My name is Dale Ruppert. I work here at Purdue University Fort Wayne as the Mechanical Engineering Laboratory Technician. So I maintain and run the laboratory spaces used by the Mechanical Engineering Department. We have had some student projects. They were working on a large computer monitor, and they were little like molded plastic brackets that held the screen above the light source in this monitor. And they would either have to scour the internet to try and find sellers of old brackets, or we could reverse engineer them and 3D print them with the resin printer. We did use Raise standard white resin. That was the first resin we had for this printer, and we were just kind of experimenting with how it would go. And when compared to the molded plastic original versions, the properties of the resin printed version stood up much better. We did have a project that actually involved an automobile, and there was a component to it that controlled the defrost and opening up vents, and it broke very easily. For this project, we did use the Loctite Pro 476 resin. We wanted to experiment to see if maybe we could get resin that had different temperature qualities, different mechanical properties. Being in an automobile where it could get really hot, it might have a lot of force on the actuator arm, and it is working in the automobile right now and is outperforming the original part currently. The other resin printer we have here on campus is an LCD technology, which is fine for standard models that you might have that might just sit on your desk or might not have to do anything. But for here in the mechanical engineering section of our lab spaces, we like to have a little more accuracy with our prints. So the DLP technology has been great. So one of the things we have printed for our students, we have this component here, which uses a laser thermometer, shines through a very small hole onto a component. And so having technology that lets us get a hole down to very small specifications was great and ended up working very well. We do have a significant amount of Raise3D printers, FDM printers in our lab, and they have been very reliable, very good printers for us. So once I saw that Raise3D had their own resin printer, that instantly made that go up to the top of my list of resin printers that I was interested in and looking to get. I love how streamlined it's all been. Essentially, it's plug and play. You put in the file you want. It has all the templates built in. It has all the settings as far as washing and curing for that particular model. One of the things, as I was getting this resin printer, that I was warned by the other part of campus that has a different resin printer, was how potentially messy the whole system could be. And so I have been very happy to see how hands-off everything has been as far as myself and the students actually having to come into contact with the resin or the isopropyl alcohol. And that has been a very great feature of this printer. I've been very happy with the software idea maker for this printer. I really like how the resins that Raise3D has used a lot with their printer has their own templates built into the software. When I put the model into the software, I essentially can tell it what resin I want it to use. And there's already a template built in there as far as settings that the print needs to have. And that's made things very streamlined and very quick and easy on our end. That being said, I also like the flexibility as far as if I were to use a resin that wasn't Raise3D brand or Loctite brand, there is ease as far as manipulating the software to make my own template. I would love to get to the point with this printer where I could create my own templates, experiment with different resins that we didn't know about. We are actively printing dog bone parts that look like this that we are going to be using in our other labs to test mechanical properties of different types of resins. And I would love to be able to make my own templates to branch out to even more resins that aren't Raise3D brand or Loctite brand and be able to test their mechanical properties with the students here on campus. Really, we're at like the tip of the iceberg as far as usage goes here with it. I feel like we definitely have like a lot of room to expand with this.